Robert Englund is officially done playing Freddy. Umberto Lenzi has passed away at 86, and we've got some new details on the It sequel. You're watching This Week in Horror. Performance as Freddy Krueger is one of the most iconic portrayals of a horror baddie there is, so it's no wonder fans have had their fingers crossed that he might someday revisit the role. If you're one of those fans, you can go ahead and uncross those wishful fingies, because sadly, Englund has gone on record to say that those days are now behind him. In a recent interview with EW, he said, "I'm too old to do another Freddy now. If I do a fight scene now, it's gonna be real minimal because I can't snap my head for 8 different takes and different angles. My spine gets sore. I can still be mean and scary, but I'm mostly relegated now to sort of Van Helsing roles, old doctors and shit." Sad news for sure, but we want Englund to be around for many healthy years to come, so I guess we can let him off the hook for that one. If you're a fan of 70s Italian horror, you undoubtedly have seen at least one of Umberto Lenzi's iconic films. Bloody Disgusting received word last week that Lenzi passed away in Rome at the age of 86. Although he is possibly best known for his work on Nightmare City and Cannibal Ferox, Lenzi has a massive catalog of work, and you can basically pick any one and have a great time watching it. We at Bloody Disgusting send our condolences to Lenzi's family and encourage you guys to binge on some classics this Halloween season in honor of Umberto's memory. Finally, it's pretty well known by now that It 2 will feature the Losers Club as adults. However, Bill Skarsgård had what I think is some pretty exciting stuff to say regarding the nature of the story when he spoke last week to IGN. He said, "The first movie works so well at what it is trying to do, I think, and ultimately that is the kid story, and you follow these kids and you sort of fall in love with these kids. And the second one will be the adult story, and I think the right way to do it is to make the movie actively different. I think there might be worth exploring sort of the psychological aspects of horror, but also maybe the sort of cosmological existence of this being. What is he and where does he come from?" One of the reasons I loved It was that it succeeded in giving childhood fears the gravity that you felt as a kid, so the idea that the second movie would adapt to the characters' fears as they are now adults makes a lot of sense to me. Skarsgård went on to say, "And you know, it's hardly answered in the novel either. I mean, it's very abstract, and I kind of like that. It could be almost a sort of surrealistic, sort of psychedelic trip if you go into the mind of Pennywise. And if you've read the novel, you know that they do actually go into his mind, or they go into this transdimensional place and they sort of beat him in this place, which might be interesting. What that place would be and what it would look like, there are opportunities, I think, and I'm excited for it." Well, I am definitely down for a psychedelic trip Pennywise exploration, but what about you guys? Let me know what you think in the comments, and if you're Halloween watch list needs some new material, a fun little indie movie that I'm in by the name of I Had a Bloody Good Time at House Harker is now out on Amazon Video. It's very gross, but also pretty sweet. We shot it in Wisconsin during a blizzard and had the best time ever, and I hope you like it. As always, keep checking back at bloodydisgusting.com for more news, and I'll see you next time.